It's the Midsummer Classic and halfway home in the Casual GTX Cup Series season 11. We are at Daytona International Speedway for the Midsummer Classic, the Pepsi 400, under the lights as we were in the Daytona 500. So let's see what happens. Here's the pole. There's the starting line for today's event. On the pole at 195 miles an hour, it's Levi McIntyre, the winner at Michigan, on the pole, alongside Tim Fiegel, the Pocono winner, number 46, that's First Union Chevrolet. Then it's Joshua Collard, the winner at Talladega, the last play track we were on. The number one Penske Chevrolet, alongside Johnny Gardner, the winner at Sonoma, and number 98, he's also a former Daytona winner. Row number three has Chris Thornton, the winner at Kentucky, on the inside of row three, alongside of him, Zed Weinstein, number 90, the Hollingmeyer's Ford. Then it's Dustin Sloniker, number 16, and the 9 of Cassandra Renzi. Then it's Charles Jackson, Mayonnaise, number 6, alongside of him, Jeff James in number 23, and in row number 5. Row 6 has Tyler Batson in 88 and Sean Galligan and Yoshi in 44. Here comes Commander. Fire him up.
Drivers, start your engines!
Sean Galligan in 44 has Yoshi has the outside row number 6. Row 7 has Jeremy Doobie, number 29, the Daytona 500 winner from season 10, alongside Cody Lamas in 15 in the Hayes Ford Thunderbird. Then it's Michael Norman, number 2, the Miller Lite Ford, had a third-place finish at Kentucky, alongside Pete Lennon, the winner at Dover, number 22, the Caterpillar Pontiac. Then it's Chris Washer in the 5, and the 28 of Keith Batson the next row down. A Ford Chevy row in the first three rows, as a matter of fact. First three rows are all Ford and Chevy. As they come out of turn number four here, getting set for a green flag here at Daytona for the Midsummer Classic, the Pepsi 400 about to get underway. Levi McIntyre leads them down, green flag waves, and boogity, 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 let's go racing, boys and girls. On the break in the turn number one, goes Levi McIntyre, number 99. In fact, he and Tim Fiegel stay locked side by side. But now Levi begins to pull out of the bench as they go in the first and second turns. Had a great finish racing the Daytona 500. Charlie Rodriguez is the one going for the Daytona sweep in the number 10 tied Ford. He starts way back in the back. As a matter of fact. But here comes Joshua Collard, car number 1, the Penske Chevrolet for Earnhardt Ganassi Racing. As he gets Chris Thornton right behind him in number 41, and the lead in the first lap will be the number 1 of Joshua Collard. And he would love to get a win at Daytona in a series. He wants to win here. And right now he has the lead, but not only momentarily, because here comes Chris Thornton, number 1, 41 on the inside of the Kodiak Chevy. He's still looking for a second win in a row. First lap here, 172 miles per hour, but they're just getting warmed up. This lap's going to be much faster here at Daytona. Dustin Sloniker, car 16, goes in second position. He's got his teammate Charles Jackson, Mayonnaise, in the third position now. I don't know why they nicknamed Charles Jackson Mayonnaise, but some say he ought to have Hellman's for a sponsor. I don't know. But anyway, Jackson runs third position right now, trying to go for second on Dustin Sloniker, as Tyler Batson in fourth position out of the 88 car. As Collard shoved up high now, Jeremy Doobie goes inside in 29, the Scooby-Doo colors. One of the two Cartoon Network cars in the field, as we discussed before, he and Cassandra Renzi. Except Doobie's car is a Chevy and Renzi's car is a Ford. Here comes, and speaking of Fords, here comes one of Dustin Sloniker on the inside of Dalton as he takes the lead here at Daytona. Completing the third lap with 13 laps to go, 16 laps of distance here in the 400. Four laps less than we have in the 500. When you talk about the one going for the Daytona sweep, that's Charlie Rodriguez. And number 10, there he is, as he gets past Jessica Shelton in 94. And now goes inside of Joshua Osborne in 35. Rodriguez right now, last time clocked in 27th position. He's right behind the 12 of Alan Cavanero. But not looking good right there in the back, though. Seth Cole is way up in the hot side, trying to get past the 44 of Sean Galligan. Keith Batson right, caught in the sucker hole in the middle. As right now, Tyler Batson takes the lead here with Jeremy Doobie in second place. Ford trying to hold off a couple of Chevys. They got two more Fords right there on the inside with Michael Norman in the 2 and the 21 of P.J. Williams, the winner at Richmond. And two of those Fords are Thunderbirds. So you got the Taurus out in front, or was out in front, I should say. And it's now Jeremy Doobie goes inside for the lead. He's going to get with the help of Michael Norman in the number 2 car, the Miller Lite Ford. Jeremy Doobie leading the lap. Here comes Michael Norman with the lead. P.J. Williams trying to go inside. He's got the shove to 31 of Dylan Poteet. Poteet now trying to go 3 wide for second. But Doobie shuts the door. But P.J. Williams shuts the door on him. Now Michael Norman takes the lead in the Miller Lite Ford. Just an explosive start in his first 5 laps here at Daytona. Lap speeds over 200 plus miles an hour. 204 in the case of Michael Norman. Cars hitting 204 miles an hour for a lot of them. As they round turn number 4, here comes P.J. Williams. And he's got Dylan Poteet. Poteet now going inside of him in the 31. Poteet coming in, 20th in standings coming in. Michael Norman. Well, got shoved up in the high by Poteet here. A couple of good buddies going at it. Both have raced side-by-side in the Internet CRA. Now going for it for the lead here at Daytona. As we said about Michael Norman, he's no veteran, he's no newcomer to the Internet Series, even though he's new to the Cashflow GTX Cup Series. But in spite of that, Michael Norman is no little name in the series. He's raced many times in the Internet CRA, well-known in the Internet community. As well as the guy about to pass him, Pichu London, is now Dylan Poteet. Another big name. He's in the lead right now as he led the lap. That time by clocked at 202.849 miles an hour. Just about halfway home here at Daytona. Deion Scott now moving his way up in the back of TJ Lick in the 25 car. Cassandra Renzi up there to 9. And so is Zed Weinstein, Mike Becker, a lot of the big names. Ian Dutton in the 18 up there as well. 8 laps down, 8 laps to go. Dylan Poteet has won the Daytona 500 before, but he's never won the Pepsi 400 in this series. Poteet, in fact, the only 2-time 500 winner in Season 5 and Season 9. He fell short of pulling off the sweep here back in Season 5, I believe. And lost out on that to Dustin Sloniker, I think, in the... No, he did lose out to Sloniker. I don't know if I forgot who he... But he lost out on that to Trent Dunham in Season 5. TJ Lick, 3 wide for the lead. He's got it here with Pichu London. Cassandra Renzi is now up there. Ian Dutta in 18. He's now making his way. He's going to go 3 wide with Pichu and Cassandra. And now Pichu London's caught way up high, though. So is Zed Weinstein in the 90. And now going into third now is Mike Becker in the King Richard Petty cars. He has one win this season. Coming at Riverside. TJ Lint, car 25, out in front. The winner at Saint Air Short Track. Ian Dunn in second. Mike Becker in third, fourth. Now when you talk about the Daytona sweeper, here he comes. Charlie Rodriguez looking to sweep Daytona this season. He's in fourth right now. And here comes Ian Dutta, car 18 on the inside, and a pair of Pontiacs making a hookup. Bring in the Ford of Charlie Rodriguez in the tan. And push and shoving TJ Lick out the dry. Rohit Vanderbilt now goes up high. Now here comes Andres Allen in the four. Andres Allen moving up his way into the top five now with the help of Dalton Day in the 17. Johnny Gardner out there, he gets into it. So is Josh Osborne. In 35, he gets into it. Five laps to go in the Pepsi 400. Dalton Day inside of TJ Lick for fifth, and he's got it. On board with Dalton Day in car number 17. Dalton came in 17th in points coming in this race. Looking to get a pick-me-up here, trying to get a win here this season. Here comes Mike Becker inside for the lead. Inside of Ian Dutta. And now Andres Allen, the points leader, shut up high now. Here comes Charlie Rodriguez, Dalton Day. He gets into it, as I said, Johnny Gardner, 98, the winner of Sonoma. He makes it 3-wide with Joshua Osborne shoving him. Four laps to go. Mike Becker trying to hold them all off here at Daytona, but the way they race, I kind of doubt it. Don't pencil in your winner yet. This is going to get crazy here. You never know who leads at the checkered flag in this race. Here comes Johnny Gardner, 98, inside. He's got Daniel Day right there. He gets into it as well. Kyle Matthews, who almost pulled off in the 500. He's going to try to get a little Daytona revenge. He wants the 400 win. Three to go for Mike Becker. Unbelievable racing. 13 laps in the books, and we are not done yet. Not by a long shot. Here at Daytona. Mike Becker out in front. Johnny Gardner trying to get move the inside. Here he comes. He's got to move the inside. He's gonna bring Kyle Matthews with him in 75. Johnny Gardner out in front of the 400 Daytona. Taking the lead here. Two laps to go. Kyle Matthews. Inside, here comes Ann Batson in the three. She makes a move. And she's got Cole Daly. Cole Daly gets into it in 24. Seth Cole gets into it. Jessica Shelton gets into it in the 94. This is going to be one wild scramble. The white flag will be waving this time by. Kyle Matthews is going to bring Ann Batson with him in the three. Kyle Matthews out in front. Can he pull it off at Daytona and trying to avenge that loss in the 500? Start finish line to come. White flag. One lap remaining at Daytona. Who's it going to be in the Pepsi 400? Seth Cole making a move to the inside of Cole Daly. Kyle Matthews deploys first. In the second goes Ann Batson. Backstretch now. What are you going to do? Batson out in the behind. Here she comes on the inside. She's gonna lean Cole Daly up high. Here comes Seth Cole on the inside. Shelton gets into it in 94. And it's Ann Batson out in front. Here they come out the fourth corner. Does Seth Cole make a move? Coming to start finish line. Checkered flag flies. Ann Batson wins the Pepsi 400 at Daytona. What a finish! Ann Batson brings the GM Goodrich Chevrolet to victory lane. And shall I say, the familiar Earnhardt colors to victory lane at Daytona in the Pepsi 400. Kyle Matthews denied again at Daytona. You gotta kind of feel for him though. In some ways, he finishes second in the 500 and he almost pulls off in the 400, but not this time, says the competitors again. But for Ann Batson, she gets her second win of the season. That's going to lock her definitely into the All-Star race as well for season 12. Average speed 201.710. And Batson gets the win here at Daytona. Second place to Kyle Matthews. Third was Seth Cole. Fourth position to Cole Daly. Fifth, Jessica Shelton. Her best finish, I believe, ever at Daytona. Joshua Collar comes from sixth. Seventh was Johnny Gardner. Stephanie Naylor, eighth. Ninth, Mike Becker. Tenth position to Jeff James. 11th, Keith Batson. 12th position, Pichu London. Joshua Osborne, 13th. 14th, Dalton Day. Charles Jackson, 15th. 16th was Andres Allen. Then Daniel Day, Sean Galligan, Charlie Rodriguez, 19th. Sokol said Daytona sweep. And TJ Lincoln's on the 10th position. The top 22 cars separated by less than 1 second. That's racing here at Daytona, that's for sure. Yeah. And it's an average speed of almost 202 miles an hour. That's tremendous. Rest of the finishing order here for today. Less than 2 seconds separated the top. Less than 2 seconds separated the whole field, I should say. Dustin Slonick are last place, and he was still 1.908 seconds back of the leader. But several big names having some bad runs. Dylan Pozzi, he was up there for a while. He is up 31st. Michael Norman, 28th. He was up there for much of the race as well. So is Tim Beagle. So is Cassandra Renzi. Chris Dalton. Zed Weinstein. A lot of the big names were way down the field, and some of them were top five in points coming in. But for Ann Batson, she gets her first win in her career at Daytona. That Jessica and that Earnhardt Colors looks good in victory lane, doesn't it? Yeah. Going to New Hampshire next on the tour for the Sylvania 300. Here's your points coming in. Andres Allen has a 23-point lead now, and Jessica Shelton in the points chase. Charlie Rodriguez is in third. Cole Daly in fourth. Ann Batson up to fifth place in the points. Sixth, Chris Washer. Seventh is Keith Batson. TJ Lick in eighth position. Ninth is Pichu London. Tenth is Seth Cole. Then Tyler Batson, Zed Weinstein, Adrian Becker, PJ Williams, Dalton Day, Ian Dutta is in 16th, 17th, Rohit Vanderveer. Then Mike Becker in 19th and 18th, Sean Galligan 19th, and 20th is Cassandra Renzi. So top four separated by within 92 points. But Andres Allen's consistency, as I said, keeps him in the lead in spite of no wins at this point. Could he win in a race? Could he win the championship without winning a race? That's a good question. Jeremy Doobie is in 38th in the points. He's still down in the basement. And some big names down there. Joshua Osborne in 21st. Dylan Poteet, 22nd. Johnny Gardner, however, moved up to 23rd in the points. Charles Jackson, 25th. Dustin Slonecker. Kyle Matthews is in 27th. He gets a little bit of a pick-me-up in some ways. Dalton 31st right now, still in the points chase. Michael Norman 30th. Your top rookie right now is Charlie Rodriguez in third place in the points. Joshua Collard, he's way down there in 36th. Of course, he missed the start at San Air. But next race on the tour will be at New Hampshire for the Sylvania 300. Don't miss it.